Hey guys, welcome to Chai Time. Today we are going to see roll puri sweet recipe. For this, take 2 cup of maida, add some salt and 2 spoons of oil and mix them well. After mixing it with oil, you'll get a nice crunchiness when you boil in water. So what now we are going to do is, we are supposed to make a dough like chapati. So for making such dough, you can add required amount of water as normal how you do for making chapati dough. After preparing the dough, you should make sure it get rested for half an hour. So just keep this dough aside after making it a good dough. Now for making sugar syrup, take a pan and put 1 glass of sugar and 1/2 glass of water and color as per your requirement. I am adding yellow food color. And make sure it doesn't get 1 stripe or 2 stripe. Just the thing is that sugar should dissolve in this water. After the sugar dissolves in the water, now we are supposed to add a few drops of lemon juice so that you know the sugar syrup won't get crystals back. And after the sugar syrup is prepared, keep it aside. Now take the rested maida dough and make it into small 5 pieces and just take the balls and just roll it to make small chapatis. Keep in mind, just make small chapatis. I will say why we are making just small chapatis here. Why we are making small chapatis is that we are actually keeping one small chapati over the another chapati. Like this, we are keeping 5 layers and then again we are rolling it. So if we do in a small chapati, then while rolling we'll get a little big, but in first only if we put a large chapatis, then while keeping 5 layer chapati and again rolling it, it will become too big where countertop or nothing will be able to, you know, roll it, and also you won't be able to roll that much big thing. So after making or rolling 5 chapatis, put some oil on first chapati and some maida flour and just spread it. And upon that, you are supposed to add one more chapati and put some oil again and some maida flour and put again the rolled chapati. Why I am using chapati word is because you all will be familiar with chapati word. That's the reason. After making 5 layer of chapatis, at last what we are supposed to do is roll again. See, this is the reason why I said you to make small chapatis. If you just start with large chapatis, it will become too large, so where we can't handle in home to roll such a big chapati. So make sure you are not rolling inside, make sure you just put pressure in middle of the roll. At last, after making it a big circular, now we are again supposed to add few drops of oil and again maida flour upon it and then roll it. Make sure the roll should be little tight. After rolling it, to seal the SS layer or the end layer, I have used 1 spoon of maida and 1 spoon of water and just mixed it up well, and I am using it to seal the roll. After sealing the roll, we can just cut them into small pieces like this and take one small piece and just lightly press with your forefinger or any other finger, but make sure you are not pressing it too hard, just give a slight press. And in a kadai, put oil as per your requirement. and then deep fry all the rolls which we have did, but make sure the flame should be too low, only then we will get crispy layered swirls. Otherwise what will happen is, due to excess heat, the middle part of the layered roll will not get crispness. So make sure you boil the swirls throughout in low flame. See, slightly the color will change and also the bubbles get reduced. This is how you can make sure that whether this is been ready to serve or not. Make sure all the bubbles will go off, otherwise you know, this will not get crispness. If all the bubbles are gone and the color is almost golden brown, which should be somewhat this color, and when it turns to this color and there's no bubble, you are supposed to take that and keep it aside and make sure you rest it for 5 more minutes, because you can't put hot swirl rolls in sugar syrup. So just make sure 5 minutes you rest these swirls, and then we can add it on the sugar syrup that we have made before. See, I have rested for 5 minutes. After resting it for 5 minutes, see, it's just crispy, and you can also see how the layers have been come out. Now I'm putting it into a sugar syrup and just giving a twist. In sense, I'm turning over the rolls in this sugar syrup. Make sure each and every rolls are being turned over, or it should be like sugar syrup should be more, and you just make sure that whole swirl roll is being inside the sugar syrup. Else you are supposed to twist like this, turn over, and make sure each and every part of this swirl is at least coated with this sugar syrup. Now leave it for 5 minutes in the sugar syrup. And after 5 minutes, now it's the time to serve. Now you can take this swirls out of sugar syrup and serve it hot. But the thing is, like, you won't get sugar syrup in the middle of this thing. If you really want the sugar syrup to be in the middle of this roll, what we are supposed to do is, we are supposed to rest this crispy roll for another half an hour in the sugar syrup. But make sure sugar syrup should be cooled, not hot. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe our channel and keep supporting. Thank you.